Ladies and gentlemen, almost 40 months after the birth of the 29th and youngest state in India, we have the privilege and the honor of welcoming to the India Today Conclave South the Bahubali of Telangana, Chief Minister, Mr. Kalvakunta Chandrasekhar Rao. Chief Minister, sir, rarely does a person in his lifetime not only win such a tremendous battle that you did, but is also gifted with the opportunity to right the wrongs that you had fought for all your life. Sir, when you took over Telangana as Chief Minister in June 2014, it faced the ills that you had always fought for, and that's why you wanted a separate state. There was a shortage of water and power. Facilities for health and education were extremely poor. And both industrial and agriculture growth was very, very sluggish. Chief Minister, sir, in the short span of time that you've been in power, you have begun to make the difference. And let the figures do the talking. Telangana's gross state domestic product, or GSDP, grew at a modest 4.2% in the 2 years preceding its formation. It has now doubled to 9.5% since it was formed. This, mind you, despite an agriculture setback because of two years of poor rainfall. This year, with the rainfall getting even better, the state's GSDP is expected to average 10.1%. As a result, Telangana is now one of the fastest growing states in the country. Please give him a warm round of applause for that. Nowhere is this growth more evident than in the manufacturing and services sector. Both these sectors were in negative growth before the state's formation. Now these sectors have been growing at an average of 8 to 10% annually. Today, Telangana is among the top 10 states in India in terms of per capita income also. Thank you. The reason for this growth is the gentleman sitting here, the Telangana Chief Minister, who has been solving the problems of the state systematically since he took charge. He addressed the acute power shortage that had affected both industrial and agriculture production. By the end of this year, ladies and gentlemen, power production in Telangana would double since it was formed. This would enable the state to ensure its citizens, farmers, and industry 24/7 power supply. Simultaneously, the Chief Minister promoted industry by bringing an innovative single window scheme. The state gives approvals within 2 weeks of an application being submitted through a process called self-certification. Over 5,300 industries worth rupees 1.15 lakh crores have set up shop since then, and it has provided employment for over 2 lakh people. But that's not enough, as you know, Chief Minister, running a state like this. You are also acutely conscious of the fact that rural economy, the villages of your state, is the key to your state's prosperity. And you have introduced two game-changing programs that Mr. Arun Puri, India Today Group's chairman, had mentioned in his welcome speech this morning. Mission Kakatiya is now underway to rejuvenate 45,000 irrigation tanks across the state. And Mission Bhagiratha will provide pipe water supply to all the 8.3 million households in the state. Both these, when completed by the end of this year, will make the state drought-proof. Please give them another round of applause for that. Chief Minister Chandrasekhar Rao's vision of a Bangara Telangana, or the golden state for all its people, is taking shape rapidly. Chief Minister, we wish you all the best in your mission to make Telangana the number one state in the country. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this India Today South Conclave 2018. And we have with us K. Chandrasekhar Rao, the Chief Minister of Telangana, the youngest state of the South. And I think we should all give him a very big applause for what he's achieved in the last 3.5 years. Mr. Chief Minister, I want to start, first of all, by taking you back to that day of June 2nd, 2014, possibly even before that, when we used to meet in Delhi, and the nervousness that existed. There was a sense of anticipation, but there was a nervousness whether Telangana could actually do it, and whether the splitting from Andhra Pradesh was the biggest mistake that Telangana and indeed Hyderabad, where we are today, was making at the time. 3.5 years later, you've settled most of the doubts. What changed in the last 3.5 years? Were you nervous on June 2nd, 2014? An honest answer, were you nervous? Have I made a big mistake?
Thank you, Rajdeep, for setting some good words in my favor. As a matter of fact, it was a great dream of the people for 7 long decades. It was a struggle started by not KCR alone. So many before me also made sincere attempts. But at that point of time, it was not possible for them to achieve the state. After a full understanding of the fizzled out moment, we had a brainstorming of at least 3,000 to 4,000 hours before we started our agitation in the year 2001. So the beginning of the agitation itself was with a full scale of understanding. It was not by emotion. We just did not come onto the road, say Jai Telangana. It was a scheme of things which we really drafted. And definitely I can say, Rajdeep, at this point of time, it's a very, very learning point for the people who fight for their causes. The way we conducted the movement, without any violence, without any destruction, all through the movement, you watched us. You was with me, we met so many times. It was not a mistake. Just now the gentleman there was giving the progress card of Telangana. I thank him too, because we were arguing during the course of agitation, once we are a state, we'll be a number one category state in the country. And we will be contributing, while reconstructing ourselves, we'll be contributing to the nation building process, which we had successfully done in the last 3.5 years and proved to the nation. I was not at all nervous, and it was not a challenge before me. Rather, it was an opportunity. Opportunity to reconstruct, rebuild Telangana, and we made the same strides. We are successful. Here one point let me mention to you very clearly. The Comptroller and Auditor General of India, who finally finalizes the figures, financial figures of all the states. I am very proud to say here today in this conclave, in this prestigious conclave, Arunji is also here. Last year, our growth rate was dictated by the Government of India. By the CAG, we were number one state in the country. This year also, like-to-like comparison to last year, by end of December, we again continue the same growth path. And we are also rated number one in at least 16 measures which are measured by Government of India, not by ourselves. EODB, we are number one. Green power production, we are number one. At the beginning, when Telangana was formed, we had only 10 megawatts of solar power. Today it is 3,500 megawatts what Telangana produces today. It's a fact.
I'll come to both the positives and the negatives, but I again want to come back to that day of June 2nd, 2014, the historic day, because the sense was that is the Telugu identity going to get split? And there were comments of yours, for example, which you had said at the time that Andhra employees will have to leave Hyderabad. There was a fear that capital would leave Hyderabad and go into Andhra Pradesh. What would Telangana have apart from Hyderabad and the infrastructure that had been built? I just want to understand, do you have regrets perhaps at any stage? Do you ever wake up in the night and say, look, I was after all responsible for splitting the Telugu identity? Do you ever feel Rajdeep, do you regret those statements you made?
Rajdeep, let me very clearly make it. The question of regret doesn't arise. Why? Because there was nothing like a Telugu identity. Nothing like Telugu identity. I'm sorry to say. Somebody may mistake.
This is being spoken by someone who was very close to NTR at one time, became part of the Telugu.
That's a different issue altogether. Andhra state was a different state. Telangana was a different identity. The culture, the festival celebrated, the language spoken, the accent, what I mean to say, the accent, everything was totally different. Even during the merger in the year 1956, all the intellectuals, all the people, all the political leaders, all the systems of Telangana have bluntly opposed the merger. But unfortunately, the state was merged. And I will today say that the formation of Andhra Pradesh was a blunder, it was a failure. And today, the separation of Andhra Pradesh is a story of success. Today I can tell you with proud, the budget proposed for this financial year was about 1,49,000 crores. I think you know the budget estimate and the budget reach. We are definitely positively going to reach the mark of spending 1,25,000 crores. The capital expenditure in the state of Andhra Pradesh was not exceeding 15,000 to 20,000 crores at any point of time. Today, Telangana's capital expenditure is reaching 50,000 crores. 50,000 crores. I will give you all the necessary account.
And there hasn't been the flight of capital that you or some others feared at the time, that those Andhraites who had kept their money in Hyderabad would take their money out of Hyderabad. That hasn't happened. To that extent, will you give credit to those who maybe hail from a Guntur, a Vijayawada, and have chosen to make Telangana and Hyderabad their home? In that sense,
Rajdeep,
this has
let
proven
me tell
human.
You, let me tell you one thing. People who are really exposed to the history of Telangana know the fact. Wealth making in Telangana began at the time of Nizams. So many people from the north, from Rajasthan, Gujarat, so many other parts of the country, they came here, they made wealth. Today, let me tell you, there is one place called in the old city of Hyderabad, that is Gulzar House. Those Marwaris who came at least 300 years back to Hyderabad, and they still say Telangana is our motherland. Except for Andhra people, there was a misgiving, misconception, mispropaganda among the Andhras by some vested interest that we will lose this, we will lose that, we will lose that. But let me tell you one thing. The major component, the major chunk of Andhra people live in Hyderabad city. The way we won the Greater Hyderabad Municipal Corporation elections, no party ever recorded such a victory. Out of 150 seats in the GHMC, myself and my colleague party, my friendly party, we won about 144 seats. All the rest of the parties left were with only 6 seats. That's a clear indication. It was a total mispropaganda. It was total misunderstanding. But it is proved otherwise.
In fact,
nobody left Hyderabad.
In fact, I am
people are coming more to Hyderabad.
In fact, I am suggesting, K. Chandrasekhar Rao, why don't you pitch for Hyderabad to be made the second capital of the country like Ambedkar wanted, because it is north of South India and south of North India. So it is ideally located in many ways. And most people believe that Hyderabad in that sense,
Rajdeep,
should represent this confluence of
Rajdeep, I want to be cutthroat here. Fortunately or unfortunately, after 70 years of exercising of democracy, we are yet to understand our country fully well. Yes, I make the comment as a responsible person in the country. See, the Finance Commission do come once in every 5 years. They give some report. Ultimately, Government of India adopts some of it and some of it not. See, today we are growing at a faster rate. Our own economic resource is on the rampant growth. We are better than Gujarat, better than Maharashtra, better than Tamil Nadu. So many manufacturing states are there, no? In spite of so many troubles in between, we made a tremendous growth. It is proved before the country. The Finance Commission of India makes recommendations to disincentivize to growing states. Let the people know it well today that wealth of a state is wealth of a nation. Cutting down or curtailing growth of any state India, any state of India is cutting the wealth of the nation. Let there be understanding. And as you mentioned, second capital, we welcome. If the nation wants, Hyderabad always welcomes such a move. We have no objection for that.
You have no objection if Hyderabad is made the second.
If whole India comes to Hyderabad, we welcome it. Well, we have no objection.
Well, all of India is coming. Certainly the IT sector and capital is coming to Hyderabad, Mr. K. Chandrasekhar Rao. But as you said, what is the secret? Is the secret formula then that small is beautiful? That in India, the smaller states are more likely to succeed in the future than the larger state? You made an interesting allusion there. You said we are better than Gujarat.
Yes.
Now, over the last 10 years, all that we have heard in this country is the Gujarat model. Are you saying there is a Telangana model in this country which is far more successful than a Gujarat model, and it's based on small is beautiful? The smaller states have a better chance of India of succeeding in India than the larger states. Maybe all of India should have many more smaller states. We should have Vidarbha tomorrow. We should have, you know, I know people in my home state of Maharashtra will attack me for this, but why should Maharashtra be split also into a couple of states tomorrow?
I beg to disagree once again with you, because Telangana is not a smaller state. We pleaded. There are 17 states which are smaller than Telangana. It may be a surprise to people to know, we are bigger than West Bengal. We are bigger than Bihar, as per the geographical contours are concerned.
In your land area?
Yes.
But your population is much
population
smaller.
Population was also, we stand at 12th place in the country. We are not small. I dispute with you. We have been pleading during the course of agitation also to convince people, to convince the then Prime Minister, to convince Srimati Sonia Gandhi and so many others like you. I was arguing there we are not going to be a smaller state. And we proved to be otherwise. We are bigger than any other state in the country in at least 15, 16 areas.
So you tell me, what is this Telangana model that you believe is superior to Gujarat? Why is Telangana in your view superior to Gujarat?
One day I was
talking
to Arun Puriji over the phone. I have requested him to come down to Hyderabad. I have requested him to come down with some senior journalists so that I can arrange an helicopter for him, so that he can go around Telangana state and see personally what is happening here. We made a stride of identifying the human resource with a different trend. Let me tell you a beautiful story. It was for me to stir up the rural economy. As the other journalist was mentioning, just before you came onto the dais, Hyderabad city, being very big, one of the big metros of the country, big metros of the world also, and the state of Telangana. When we incepted, Telangana state used to import about 650 lorry loads of sheep every day. Every day. Sheep used to come from Rajasthan, so many other states in the country. We have designed such a beautiful program, and it is proved to be so successful. We have taken up that particular work in a mission mode and secured a loan of 5,000 crores from the NCDC. Then we started distributing the sheep. People were laughing at me initially. Today, I can tell you, successfully we have implemented that program by way of distributing 38 lakh sheep today, and the lambs born to them are another 13 lakhs. Telangana today added 50 lakh sheep population after the inception of the state. And the sheep is a moving bank. Moving bank. I can say it's a moving bank. Telangana will start exporting meat, processed meat, very well processed meat, to the entire country and to all the foreign countries also. Very shortly we'll start that.
So basically, if Gujarat has the lion, Telangana has the sheep.
No problem.
Right? Okay, that's
lion or sheep doesn't matter. Only thing, who makes the fast buck is the matter.
Well said. You know,
it's creating wealth. That really matters, no?
you know, you have an interesting model here, because what I see is,
Rajdeep, let me in Telangana. No, let me also mention here. At one point in time, I was propagating, because when we incepted, the power situation was very grim. It was really very tough. It was a real challenge for us. But we could overcome the crisis in such a manner. Within 6 months of time, we started supplying 24 hours power for the industry and 10 hours power for the agriculture, 24 hours power supply to the domestic needs. Today, I am proud to say our installed capacity when we incepted was only 6,000 megawatts of power, out of which 2,800 megawatts was the hydel power, which was not a firm power. Now, today, the installed capacity of Telangana is about 14,000 megawatts. And very shortly, by the year 2020, the installed power capacity of Telangana is going to be 28,000 megawatts.
Power is a potential big success. But if I were to turn to an area of concern, and it remained a concern even before Telangana was formed, which is irrigation. And essentially, you've got a situation where in terms of farm suicides, Mr. Chief Minister, your state is the second highest number of farm suicides in the country after Maharashtra. 2014, we had 898 farm suicides. 2015, 1,358. You've had a couple of bad monsoons. The fact is that the farmer of Telangana may not be celebrating as much as possibly those today living in Hyderabad are. Is that a dark area for you at the moment? A blot in a way on your record?
Not at all, because when we incepted, I'll take a little more time here, Rajdeep, because let people know what exactly is happening here. My first priority, you have rightly mentioned, the number of suicides by farmers was much more. It was a distress. It was a very painful area where we were suffering. Suicides by farmers was not alone the issue. The weavers were also committing suicides.
Yes.
Because the state, the whole region, was under great distress. We thought it's our duty, it's our bounden duty to relieve people from the trauma. And we designed such a welfare bouquet. The pensions we have taken from 2,000 rupees, we call them as Asara pensions, from 200 rupees to 1,000 rupees. For the handicapped people, we pay 1,500 rupees a month. No country pays, no state pays. And the PDS system, the previous governments were giving 4 kg per person. We removed that capita, and 20 kg was the cap for a family. We have removed the cap, and we have increased from 4 kg to 6 kg per person. And any number of people are there in the family, they can get the rice. Like this, so many things we have designed. We spend more than any state in the country towards the welfare. It's about 40,000 crores of rupees per annum we spend on subsidization, only to bring the society out of the vulnerable situation, where the suicides can be stopped, where some constant confidence can be instilled, confidence can be infused. And from there, I am now coming to the agriculture. Agriculture also, Telangana is going to become a role model to the country. Yes, I can proudly say that. Now, as far as the irrigation is concerned, Telangana was allotted with water, but that always remained on paper, always remained in the secretariat, in the files, but it was never materialized on the ground. The projects which were envisaged, which were contemplated to flow in Telangana, were never completed. And now, we have an allocation of about 1,350 TMC of water in Godavari and Krishna. We started doing wonders in irrigation sector. Recently, the Central Water Commission of India has come down to Hyderabad. They were in a word of praise, such a praise, that we have not seen this kind of effort. That was what I was requesting Arunji to come and see, Kaleshwaram project, which is a prestigious project. Our mission was to complete the ongoing projects like Devadula, Nettempadu, Kalvakurti, Bhima. We have completed them. Now, Palamuru district, Mahabubnagar district, from where the migration was about 15 to 20 lakhs, more than half population was migrating. I am proudly putting it to you today. Now, today you can go and see 6.5 lakhs acres is under cultivation, paddy crop is under cultivation in Mahabubnagar district.
So will the farm suicides in your view stop? Will they decline?
It is going to definitely come down. Another thing which I would like to mention to you, with an estimate of 1.5 lakh crores we have taken up three major projects. One, Kaleshwaram to take water from Godavari. Another is Palamuru lift irrigation to take water from Krishna. Another one is Sitarama lift irrigation in Khammam district, again drawing water from Godavari. Once these projects are complete, you will see Telangana irrigating about 1 crore acres. 1 crore acres. We will make it a reality by 2020, by end of 2020. By 19 June, water will come, and the field channels, distribution network, all that to complete, that will take one more year. By 2020, I welcome you to Telangana, Rajdeep. I'll take you. I can show you proudly that Telangana is today irrigating about 1 crore acres. Another one more thing. The supply of fertilizer was erratic. Spurious seeds were on the rampant. The distress among the farmers, it was there for so many reasons, various reasons. Now we have settled the things. Godown capacity of Telangana was only 4 lakh metric tons. Now we have taken it up to 23 lakh metric tons. Now fertilizer is made available on the right time. Spurious seed is out. We are booking them in Preventive Detention Act. One more thing, one important thing is, we have designed a program which we are going to start from this year. We are going to give investment support to about 71 lakh farmers of the state of Telangana, 8,000 per acre per annum. 8,000 per acre per annum. When I had been to Delhi recently, I met Mr. Rajnath Singh, the Home Minister of the country. I told him, he asked me, Bhai Sahab, aap de rahe, kitne kiston mein wapas karna hai? Maine kaha, wapas dena hi nahi hai. Ye kisan ke paas hi reh jayega. We have designed such a scheme. Another one point which we need to ensure is to ensure the minimum support price to the farmers, for which we have again initiated, we have taken an initiative called Raitu Samanvaya Samiti, which is going to play a vital role for ensuring the MSP to the farming community.
You know, when I see you throwing these figures at me, when I see you telling me about these schemes and the timetables, you seem to be part of this new generation of chief ministers who are determined in a way to take their state up and compete with other states. Now, forget about the Gujarat model versus Telangana. That's the lion versus the sheep. Is there also competition, Mr. Chief Minister, somewhere between you and Chandrababu Naidu? Is there somewhere he wants to make Amravati and Andhra the showpiece for the future? You want to make Hyderabad and Telangana the showpiece for the future? Kahin na kahin, is that old rivalry still there? This time for the positive, that you are competing with each other. If he irrigates so much of land, you will irrigate more.
Sorry to dispute once again with you.
No, you are
because why? Because you cannot compare Telangana with Andhra. You cannot compete.
He says, I am starting today. A new state. At least K. Chandrasekhar Rao had the benefit of Hyderabad.
Rajdeep, it's not the question of benefit of Hyderabad. What was there in Singapore? Except the human intellectual. What was there? I know very well. The world knows very well. Today, what is the price of the Singapore dollar? How they had no landmass, they have no mines, they have no forests, they have nothing except brain. With their brain, where there was nothing, they have created a lot of wealth and they have become a role model under the leadership of Mr. Lee Kuan Yew. That's the best model. And I'm sorry, please do not compare Telangana with Andhra Pradesh. Because we were a surplus state when we were an independent state called Hyderabad. We were pleading all through the agitation that once separated, we will be in the first 2 or 3 or 4 states bouquet. And I am there today, not in the 3-4, but as a number one state, as far as our own resources concerned. Yes, it's not my figures, Rajdeep. I am not proclaiming. These are the things declared by Finance Ministry, Government of India.
So no competition between Telangana and
Andhra? Not at all. It cannot be.
You've already moved ahead.
Yes, we are much ahead. Not mere ahead, much, much ahead.
You know, the fact of Hyderabad itself, you know, there was a period where, as I said at the start, there was an uncertainty over its future. Yet every figure now shows Hyderabad on the up. One worrying picture, though, that we had this year was, or in 2017, when there were rains, large parts of Hyderabad, it appeared the infrastructure was unable to cope up with the rains. In that sense, do you see Hyderabad as a showpiece city? You mentioned Singapore. Are you going to make Hyderabad Singapore, or is Amravati, dare I say again, going to be the next Singapore?
I don't want to compare with Gujarat or with Singapore. It is not correct to compare with anybody.
What's your vision for Hyderabad?
See, there is a city called Mumbai. Can I compete with Mumbai?
Yeah, sure.
See, the way competing with somebody else is not desirable. Grow yourself. Do yourself. Put up your best effort. Try to grow. That is the best positive way of approach.
But what's your vision for Hyderabad? Because there's a fear that urban infrastructure is unable to cope up with the growth of Hyderabad.
Yeah, let me tell you here. Today, Hyderabad is a place where so many international conclaves, conferences take place. It's a beautiful city, as you know it very well. It's a truthful cosmopolitan city. People understand Hyderabad as the miniature of India. Because all kinds of food, all kinds of language, all kinds of cultures, it's an amalgamation of, it's a mixture, truthful mixture of Indian culture. Let me tell you here, we have been pleading the destruction of Hyderabad was so much in the integrated state. It was a beautiful city. It had power supply much before Madras had it. Hyderabad was a well-lit city in the year 1915. Madras got power only in the year 1927. 12 years later, Hyderabad had the power. It was such a beautiful city. It had all the airports, telegram, railways, road transport system. It had its own airlines, Deccan Airlines. All that was there. And when there was no underground drainage system in the whole country, Hyderabad had the underground system. The drinking water, power, underground. It was a clean city. In fact, the growth in the integrated city, the growth of Hyderabad was haphazard. All the people who were ruling Andhra Pradesh were never concentrated on Hyderabad. Rather, they contributed for the destruction of the beautiful city. Thousand lakes, the city was known, city of pearls, city of lakes. The Kuli Kutub Shah, who was the founder of Hyderabad city, unko kisi ne pucha ke bhai kya bana rahe? Jannat bana rahe. Jannat has another meaning. Jannat has the meaning of garden, public garden. Say, beautiful garden. It was a city of gardens. All that was destructed. All the rainwater drains have been captured, occupied. All that was allowed during the course of Andhra Pradesh. Now recently, when I visited China, I went to the bank. I approached the chairman there. He has promised me to give about 20,000 crores of loan to reconstruct Hyderabad in the desired manner. If we have to make the Hyderabad city as a truthfully global city, we have to invest about 20 to 25,000 crores of rupees to come out of the problems which you have mentioned.
Because my worry is Hyderabad will otherwise become like Bengaluru, a city which is simply collapsing under the weight of the growing population.
We will not allow it to go.
You will not allow that
to
happen.
We will not allow it.
You will allow it to remain the city of the lakes, the city of
exactly,
pearls.
Exactly, exactly.
You know, I must ask you this, Mr. Chief Minister, because one of the more contentious decisions that you've taken is 12% reservations that you are giving to Muslims in jobs, in education. This has now gone to the center. Many are saying that this will be struck down in the courts. What prompted you to do that? Is it vote bank politics, as is feared when reservations are given for the minorities?
One should understand very fairly here. The tribal population of Telangana, in context of the population of Telangana, is up to 10%. It was counted as 6% in the integrated state. The minority population of Telangana is also to the level of 14%. It is up to the government of India. I have also met the Prime Minister, explained him sufficiently. It's a different dimension, different understanding, different population scenarios in the states of our country. It is up to the government of India to rise, come forward, allow the states to go ahead with the reservations.
You believe every state should have their own independent reservation policy?
Yes, yes, it should be allowed. The larger population like Jharkhand, what is happening there? ST population is very high. We put an embargo of 50%. How can they do justice to the people there? Today, Telangana, I will say, Rajdeep, the composition of Telangana state today is 90% is SC, ST, minority, BC, and 10% are the OCs. How can I satisfy the people here with 50% reservations? Now, it is high time for the government of India to raise up to the level of the expectation of the people of the nation.
You are saying something very controversial.
Yes,
Mr. Chief
it's
Minister.
Not controversial. Neither it is controversial nor it is contentious. I am sorry to say.
You are saying that 50% reservation is not enough as prescribed
not
by the
at
Supreme
all, not at all. Not
so
at all.
If I have 90% SC,
it will be doing injustice to the poorer sections of the country, weaker sections. I emphasize this, and we are going to raise a big fight during the next budget session. The same matter, you will see the parliament.
You are treading into very dangerous terrain.
Not at all.
Tomorrow
not at all.
Tomorrow someone dangerous. Will say 90% reservations.
People who are not going to fall in my line, they will be in danger, not KCR.
This is not a political move that you
not
are making
all.
With one
not
eye on the elections.
Not at all, sir. And another thing.
You know that the Supreme Court will strike it down, sir.
Rajdeep, please bear with me. This is a very important issue. It's a national level issue. This issue doesn't pertain to one single state. Now, today, Tamil Nadu implements 69%.
Yes.
Right? How it is allowed? Same southern state, which is my neighboring state. What answer I should give to my people? And today, the state of Maharashtra implements 52%. Yes.
But religious-based reservations? Religious-based reservations?
It's neither religion nor caste, bhai. It's economic level.
No, when you say 12% for Muslims, effectively, you're
saying... I'm sorry. I never said Muslims. Even our bill doesn't mention Muslims. They are socially, economically backward. It is up to the country or the state to raise and understand the things, make a clear vision, and to provide reservations to the people who deserve it.
You made an interesting point. You said that you went and met the Prime Minister.
I told him.
On this. How is your relationship with the Prime Minister? The reason I'm trying to, I'm asking this is, would you concede that Sonia Gandhi and the Congress gave you Telangana? You then chose to go on your own just before the elections. And now that Mr. Modi is in power at the center, you built an equation with him. You've learned the good Hyderabadi way of doing business. Modi ke saath bhi business. And when you had to do it, you did it with Sonia Gandhi as well. KCR has kept everyone happy at the right time. And now you've moved on your own.
See, the thing is, if I don't do business the required way, I am illogical. I have to be logical, you know. My interest is my state. My interests are my people. Neither it is silly politics or any other thing. People may understand in a different issue. See, and any chief minister in the country has to maintain a constitutional relation with the government of India. State and center, there has to be a cordial constitutional relation. We are maintaining that. We are positively maintaining that. Whether Modi is going to reciprocate or not, it is up to him. It is up to him.
Are you equidistant from both the Congress and the BJP? Because
yes, we are an equal
distance. When Amit Shah came to Hyderabad a few months ago, he said that we are going to make an attempt to build the BJP and form a state government one day in Telangana. The Congress is the one that attacks you the most for alleged corruption. I am trying to understand. Where will KCR be in this?
Rajdeep, the problem is attacking, alleging corrupt practice and all that has become a fashion to the Congress party. People know in the state who was corrupt and who is non-corrupt. It is in the experience of the people. मैं आपको एक बात साफ बताना चाहूँगा.
Sir,
I was propagating during the TS I-pass of Telangana. People were unable to believe. I said, with full strength, with full confidence, I said, there are single windows elsewhere in the country, elsewhere in the world, but they are with grills. The single window offered by Telangana is without grills. And we proved it. We have accorded clearances, permissions, allocations, allotments, everything required within 15 days as promised by the state government. Within 15 days. 5,000 such industries have got the clearances and 2,000 have come to production. Rest are in the process. They will come to production very soon without paying a single naya paisa to anybody. Neither to private, not to the officers.
But you are happy with this situation of ekla chalore. You will not touch, you will not go along with the BJP. Congress will remain your main opposition in Telangana. And the TRS will build itself independently of the Congress and the BJP. No question of aligning with anyone. In the past, you've been part of the UPA and the part of the NDA. Is that chapter over now?
See, the question is, we are independent. We would like to be independent. And we don't see any requirement for us to go with anybody. Anybody may come with us, but we don't want to go with anybody.
we have
no such requirement.
You know, you've done remarkable work, as I said, in improving business confidence, in IT, in irrigation, now in power. Why then, Chief Minister, do you still believe so much in Vastu? I must ask you this, because there is this big, whenever I've come to Hyderabad, I've read these reports that the Chief Minister wants to shift the secretariat because the Vastu of the old secretariat is bad. And you're going to spend 100 crore plus on a new secretariat. If everything is going so well, why believe in Vastu?
It is not 100 crores, Rajdeep. Let me correct. It is about 250 crores to be spent to build a new secretariat. Number one. Number one is, if you want, I can take you to the secretariat. How zigzag it is, how bad it is. It's on a 25 acres of ground, which is not in the correct line. Some foreign delegates which came to me, one Mr. Velu, is a Malaysian minister, very senior most minister, he right told on my face, Mr. Rao, why don't you sell off this land and build a new capital city like Putrajaya in Malaysia? I said, Hamara desh bada sentimental hota bhai, wo kahenge ke mukhyamantri ne secretariat bhej diya, to isliye hum nahi bhej sakte. I said, I will do my best to construct a beautiful new secretariat. And Rajdeep, let me tell you one thing. Number one, as we propagated during the course of agitation, we proved to be right that we are not a poor state, but we are a rich state. And I'm sure that we will become the richest state of the country very soon. I'm very confident. And a state of this stature should have a beautiful secretariat, excellent secretariat, with all conveniences, with all modern equipments, with all communicative areas, everything should be there.
Many of your critics say, secretariat ki kya zarurat hai? You only have to go to the chief minister's house. That is where all the work is done.
It's not my house. It's my official residence.
You built an even more opulent, beautiful residence with a 5 crore vanity van. The chief minister is living life. He's the new Nizam of Hyderabad.
If some fools understand like that, I can't help it. But the thing is, the building complex which I have constructed is called Pragati Bhavan.
Yes.
In which I have a residence, I have an office, I have a beautiful hall to interact with people, with so many stakeholders, so many groups, social groups, NGOs. It's a complex of buildings. It's not mere residence of the chief minister. And it is not the residence of Mr. KCR. It is the resident of the proud state of Telangana, proud of the state. It's the place of the chief minister. It will be there at least for 100 years. So many chief ministers will come after KCR. It's not chief. KCR alone is not going to live there.
You know, you mentioned on more than one occasion today the notion of Telangana pride and the emotional outburst. And I saw it when I came in those years as you were agitating your fast unto death and other moments where there was this emotional upsurge. There are still those who will say that once the state was formed, the emotions have been replaced by traditional politics. And one of the criticisms is that what was Telangana pride is now family pride. Your daughter is an MP, your son is a minister, your nephew is a minister, and this is one KCR and family and sons, which now family, sons and daughters, that runs Telangana.
Rajdeep, it is rot right now. It was one KCR and his son, his family was also leading the agitation, facing so many police cases, arrests, going to jail, we were on the streets. The whole state knows it. And those children of KCR were elected by the people. I never nominated them to any post. They were elected as MPs, MLAs, not once, twice, thrice, like that. It's a test to go through, you know. It's people's will, people's mandate.
No, my friend here, Keshav Rao, is here from the TRS. Is the TRS a party of people from who come from different walks of life, or is the TRS become like many regional parties, Mr. KCR, a party of the family? This is a criticism that is often made of regional parties. You come to power
let
on
me
regional
tell you,
pride,
let
become
me,
a family party.
Rajdeep, let me tell you, my family is Telangana. First of all, one has to accept that.
Your family is Telangana?
Yes. Every Telangana is part of my family, definitely. And the way we are winning the elections, all by-elections, which came across in the last 3.5 years, we were winning with a very, very exemplary
without
margins.
EVM support. You don't even need EVM support here, right? When everybody...
It's a different story altogether.
This is the one state where no one has raised the issue of EVMs. You keep winning elections. What is the form? You know, I've gone through over the last 3 years, municipal election, district elections. You seem to be winning every election. Has that made you super confident? I sense in you today, sir, a confidence that I never even saw when you were a minister at the center.
See, any political leader, any political party will only become confident with the support of the people. It's the will of the people. Election is definitely will of the people, you know. It definitely reflects. Recently, there were elections to some panchayat by-elections recently, which the TRS party swept away.
Do you have no ambitions then beyond Telangana? Are you so happy now here that you rarely come to Delhi? We rarely see you. You rarely interact with the media. This is probably your first interaction that you've done with the media since you came to power. It almost seems that this is your comfort zone. Have you decided that your ambition is to build a strong Telangana?
Rajdeep, this is...
And not move to Delhi. No Delhi ambitions. You used to treat us to such lovely Telangana food when you were there in Delhi. Even that we miss.
And I definitely feel sorry for that. I will shortly make it in Delhi. As a matter of fact, I'm due to host a very good dinner Telangana with a Telangana flavor, which I hosted during the course of agitation when I was minister there.
That's right.
I'm going to definitely host and I will definitely invite you. The thing is...
Extremely spicy.
My emotions are, extremely spicy, as Telangana is. Because you know the taste of the biryani of Hyderabad, how delicious it is. Though it is spicy, it is very delicious. Even Bill Clinton, when he came, he was asking for more and more for Hyderabad biryani. Any American president or anybody, they relish more with Hyderabad biryani. So now, my field of action is Telangana. My emotions are linked here. And still we have to make so many things here. So I have no interest in Delhi. We'll be independent. We'll be here. We are comfortable here. My only aim is to make Telangana the number one state in the country.
Is that therefore, in conclusion, you think the ways the future of this country should be seen? That every state and every chief minister at one level competes with each other, takes pride in the fact that my state is moving ahead, is becoming number one. India cannot be run from Delhi. The BJP, remember, sir, is in power in 20 states. Are we saying that India cannot be run from Delhi, that the real energies of India today are in the state capitals, in the state chief ministers? If there were businessmen today watching this conclave, they should think, rather than go to Delhi to try and get things done, come to state capitals. That is where India's energies are.
If somebody accepts, somebody doesn't accept. It's a fact that India lives in the states. Let us not forget it. It's a federal structure, which has been clearly defined in the Constitution of India. The federal structure will have its own fashion. It should continue.
Because now we have a chief minister who's prime minister. So maybe even Narendra Modi has benefited from the fact that he was chief minister of Gujarat for 12 years before he became prime minister.
I definitely appreciate Mr. Modi for one thing. He has improved the tax allocation, which was 30%. He has taken it up to level of 42%. I appreciate him at that point. He also gave a slogan, cooperative federalism. When he formulated Niti Aayog, of which I am also a part, he very clearly said, he made, I think, not less than 1 hour speech, in which he was telling very clearly, by school aapko chalani hai, dawakana aapko chalani hai, falani cheez karni hai, to sare cheez aapko hi karne hai, Delhi se hame kya matlab hai. That is the right, true spirit. But he has to strictly implement it.
Is he implementing it? Is there cooperative federalism in this country?
He is partially implementing it. He is yet to implement it fully.
What would your message be to Prime Minister Modi, who may be watching you today?
Let him watch. I will be very happy. I have given a positive message. It will certainly help him. He has to take it in a positive manner.
Now, what is the cooperative federalism bit that you would like him to implement that you believe he is not implementing?
He should devolve more funds to the states, devolve more powers to the states. That should be the slogan of the day. Unless you make the state powerful, you will never be powerful. I mentioned initially that wealth of any state in the country should be considered the wealth of the nation. Curtailing any state, it is curtailing the growth of the nation. Let the nation do not forget it. Dekhiye, ek bar, when I was Minister Rajdeep in Delhi, there was a big tsunami in Tamil Nadu. As a union labor minister, I have sent 300 doctors on barefoot basis using my own discretion. After that, I informed the Prime Minister and he patted me. Dr. Manmohan Singh patted me. You did a good work. See, when you are a part of a big economy, some parts may be growing faster, some parts may be with slow pace. So the wealth should be distributed equally, but the center should allow the growing states to grow further, produce more wealth. That becomes the national wealth ultimately.
I think you put it beautifully, Mr. Chief Minister. The future of this country lies in appreciating the mosaic of states which we are part of. A true cooperative federalism is the way forward. And South India's newest state and one of the younger states in the country has proven what you can do if you have the will. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to ask you to give a big hand to the Chief Minister of Telangana. We just about have time for a couple of questions. If there are people out there, the Chief Minister is more than willing to take a couple of questions. If you have a question, yes, out there, just give the mic there. Yes.
Really, it's a great interaction between Rajdeep Desai and the Chief Minister. I'm proud to say that the youngest state in India is Telangana. When he became a Chief Minister, he did a wonderful job. What he promises, delivers it. And the most important thing, I want one request. All the NRIs, those who are in Gulf, we need a support from you once they come back over here. What you are going to give them, at least a piece of land or a small investment where they can survive their life. Because when they are in the Gulf, they don't have any immigration like states when they have the green card. So when they come back after spending years, so they need some pension over here.
Basically, he wants a Pravasi Telangana Divas.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
I understood it very well. He is only trying to explain the problems faced by the NRIs of the Gulf.
Yes.
We have NRIs in US, Europe, and so many parts of the globe. They are not facing similar problems as the Gulf. They are facing. We are sympathetic. The NRI policy is under preparation. Dr. Keshav Rao is also looking into that. I think shortly we will come up with a positive policy to help the NRIs who are the sufferers in the Gulf.
I'm afraid we've run completely out of time. Okay, the gentleman here, one last question. You've picked up the mic. I can't stop you. Okay.
Chandrasekhar Rao garu, namaskaram. Meekante oka 6 endlu peddavadu nenu. 69 education lo jail lo unnanu. College Narayana Rao garu toti bhujam kalisi tiriginanu. Meer education nadichinappudu kuda meeto direct kaakuna indirect ga సహకరించిన వ్యక్తిని నేను నర నరంలో వచ్చి తెలంగాణ జీర్ణించుకున్నవాడిని. ఒకటే కేటీఆర్ను ఒకసారి ప్రవాస్ తెలంగాణ డెవలప్మెంట్ ఫోరంలో కూర్చున్నప్పుడు అడిగినాను, 69లో జైల్లో ఉన్న వ్యక్తులను నిస్వార్థంగా తమ బతుకులను తెల్లవారజేసిన వాళ్ళను ఒక్కసారి ఒక స్టేజ్ మీదకి తీసుకొచ్చి గౌరవించండి. తామ్రపత్రాలు అవసరం లేదు, మాకు పెన్షన్ అవసరం లేదు, ఇంతవరకు జరగలేదు. నా పేరు ప్రతాప్ రెడ్డి. నాకు చంద్రబాబు నాయుడు వైస్ ఛాన్సలర్ లేకపోతే తన్నితే బయటికి వచ్చి పరుపుల పడ్డా. ధ్రువ కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ మేనేజ్మెంట్ని పెట్టుకున్నా, హాయిగా ఉన్నా. కానీ నాకు కావాల్సింది ఏంటంటే 69లో కష్టపడ్డ వాళ్ళు నిస్వార్థంగా జైల్లోకి పోయిన వాళ్ళు గుర్తింపు
ఫెసిలిటేట్ ది
69
ప్రతాప్ రెడ్డి గారు తప్పకుండా.
వాళ్ళు ఇంగ్లీష్లో అడుగుతున్నారండి, మీ అంత ఇంగ్లీష్ నాకు రాదు, మీ అంత తెలుగు అస్సలు రాదు, కానీ ఐఎమ్ కంఫర్టబుల్ ఇన్ ఇంగ్లీష్ టు. I was incarcerated in 1969 Telangana agitation, and I'm ahead of you by 6-7 years. I'm 75, and I rubbed shoulders with likes of College Narayan Rao garu, and I heard you and I appreciated your approach, non-partisan approach compared to Chennareddy also.
What's your question, sir?
Chennareddy sakka chesinnadi.
So what's your question?
Meeru em chesinnante 69 agitation, those who have fought without any hesitation, without any reservation, without any partisan approach, why don't you bring them on a platform and say hello?
Pratap Reddy garu, 69 agitators gurinchi nenu chaala vivaralu teppichinam. Dadaapu ippatiki oka 55 mandiki kotha sahayam kuda chesinam. Tappakunda mana amaravirula stoopanni jaladushyam pakkana chaala pedda etana kadta unnam. Aa సందర్భాన్ని పురస్కరించుకొని మేము సన్మానించుకోవాలి, గౌరవించుకోవాలన్నటువంటి సదుద్దేశంతో ఉన్నాం. షార్ట్ పీరియడ్లో తప్పకుండా జరుగుతుందండి, డెఫినెట్లీ.
బేసిక్లీ హీ సేయింగ్ యూ నీడ్ టు సెలబ్రేట్ ఇన్ అ వే ఆల్ దోస్ హూ స్పెండ్ దేర్ లైవ్స్ ఫైటింగ్, ఐ ప్రెజ్యూమ్, ఫర్ ద స్టేట్ ఆఫ్ తెలంగాణ.
సర్టెన్లీ, ఇట్ ఇస్ అవర్ డ్యూటీ, ఇట్స్ అవర్ డ్యూటీ, బికాస్ దే ఆర్ అవర్ ఎన్సెస్టర్స్ హూ రియలీ ఫాట్ ఫర్ తెలంగాణ.
వెల్, యూ వర్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ దట్ ఫైట్ రైట్ ఫ్రమ్ ద బిగినింగ్. యూ హవ్ సీన్ ద ఫైట్ ఫర్ తెలంగాణ ఓవర్ సెవరల్ డెకేడ్స్. టుడే యూ ఆర్ ప్రిసైడింగ్ ఓవర్ ద ఫార్చూన్స్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ new young forward looking state. Ladies and gentlemen, for one last time, please give a big hand to K. Chandrasekhar Rao, the Chief Minister of Telangana.
Thank you so much.